Leanne. And then the spirit of Curtis woke me up.
You hypnotized yourself?
No, no, no. I had a nap. And then his presence filled the room.
Mum, can you please not scare the kids with your mumbo jumbo?
What are you talking about? Pikitea's father saved her from certain death.
What actually happened to her?
A blanket fell on her face.
A heavy one?
No, this muslin thing.
Aww. Did you wiggly wiggly out of your blankie?
Wiley used to do that.
Yes, I didn't feel it.
Oh, okay, so nobody's interested. Charming.
It was your motherly instinct, Leanne. That's what woke you up.
No, no, it was a warning, a message. But I can't quite tune in.
A message from Curtis?
Yes.
What do you think he's trying to say?
Don't encourage her.
Well, I better call Esther.
No, no, you better not.
Well, she needs to know.
What, that you fell asleep on the job? You'll never babysit again.
Lie to the mother.
No, I just mean don't
trust you to come up with a plan of deception.
Mother is okay. Let's just leave it.
Well, I can't. How was your letdown reflex? Work okay?
Took a few minutes.
Well, you did seem a bit tense.
It's because I am.
Are you picking up an energy, a sense of foreboding?
It's just a work issue.
Right, because I thought I might have brought it in with me.
Sorry?
I have something to confess. Nicole wanted me to hide it from you, but full transparency.
Okay.
So when Pikitea had her nap, I nodded off.
That's okay, I do that all the time.
No, no, it's not good. The sheet was covering her face.
Well, she was okay, though.
Only because of Curtis.
Hmm?
He spoke to me. His spirit woke me up. Leanne. Leanne.
Well, you were just dreaming.
No, no, he was watching over his daughter.
Leanne, please let him rest in peace.
You don't believe me.
Well, you do have a wild imagination.
But you understand the spirit world. And that girl that you saved, oh, what was her name?
It's Jessie.
Sorry?
Jessie,
yes, that's it. You had visions.
Look, I miss him too. Okay, and I wish that he was here. I wish he was still alive, but he is gone.
Esther, embrace it. It's a good thing that he's here with us.
No, he's not. And don't talk like that around my baby. That kind of talk is no good.
Okay. I'll let you get back to your work, eh? And little princess, we'll get going, eh? Oh, Marty, how can you live with a squawking baby like that, day in and day out?
I don't mind one bit. What's wrong, little one? You hungry?
Oh, she can't be.
Nappy time?
No, just done all that.
Oh, you just want some company, don't you? You want someone to talk to? Well, you go ahead and talk to us, eh?
Oh. Well done.
I got lucky.
No, 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 it's more than that. She trusts you. In fact, can you feel that?
Feel what?
Oh, the heaviness. It's gone.
Sorry?
Oh, never mind. Anyway, it's going to be a rocky road for a young mum like Esther, all on her own.
I'll help her.
Even when she's a hot and confused mess. Okay? Great patience will be required, Marty. Especially from those who are closest.
I know.
Marty just got her back to sleep.
I'm just going for a run. I'll see you later.
Well, he couldn't get out of here quick enough.
My fault?
Yeah, I heard.
Did he say something?
No, no. No, of course not. Marty wouldn't. No, the gossips dished it up at work.
Right, so everyone knows.
I didn't even question Marty. I knew I'd never get anything out of him. He is a man of integrity.
Yeah, I know.
And I know, deep in my soul, that Curtis would approve. So don't feel guilty about looking at Marty.
There's nothing going on yet.
Oh, yes, there is. But I know, it's too early for you yet. And Marty knows that. But the question is, how long will he wait?
I don't want him to wait.
Esther, how many Martys do you think there are in this world? Don't let this one pass you by.
It's too soon to think about all of that.
Life is too short to wait for the perfect timing. You know that. Chances can just slip away.